Hello everyone. This is a very brief tutorial on a little known but very useful feature, using markers in the timeline to switch the active camera when creating an animation in Blender. Sometimes you may need to render a scene by changing the framing during the animation, perhaps with moving cameras. The camera used for rendering is called the active camera, which is specified in the camera field in the scene tab within the properties window, and it can be changed on the fly using specific tools called markers, as we will see. This tutorial was created with Blender version 4.2, but markers and the ability to switch cameras on the fly during animation playback have been available in various versions of the software. The scene I'm using contains three cameras, each with its own animation, but of course, the example can be extended to any number of camera objects. The first thing to do is choose the frames where you want to change the framing, i.e. the active camera, by inserting markers. This operation is done in the timeline and does not involve the camera objects. Let's place the first marker right at frame 1 of the video clip. The process is very simple. Just open the marker menu in the timeline and select Add Marker. The keyboard shortcut is the M key, but be careful. It must be pressed while the mouse cursor is in the timeline window, otherwise it will perform different actions depending on the active window. The default name for markers is composed of the letter F followed by an underscore and the frame number, but we can rename it to something more meaningful. For example, at frame 1, we open the marker menu in the timeline, select Rename Marker, and type Camera 1 in the field that will appear on the screen. Now we need to link the desired camera to the marker. This operation is called binding and can be done with a Ctrl+B shortcut or by using the Bind Camera to Marker tool found in the marker menu in the timeline. Select the camera object you want to use and, with a mouse cursor in the timeline, press Ctrl+B. Note that after binding a camera, Blender will rename the marker with the name of the chosen camera. So the two steps are these: create a marker and press Ctrl+B with a camera you want to associate with the selected marker. Let's go to frame 80, select another camera, insert a marker, and associate the selected camera to the marker using Ctrl+B. Now let's go to frame 160 and repeat the process with a third camera, create a new marker, and perform a new binding with the selected object. Of course, you can later change the association between the camera and the marker to use a different camera, or you can delete the marker altogether and skip the switch. In the marker menu of the timeline, you'll find some useful tools for working with these special items. To see which camera is active and will be used for rendering the current frame, you need to choose the Active Camera option from the View Camera menu of a 3D viewport. The shortcut for this tool is the 0 key on the numpad. Now all that's left is to go to the first frame of the timeline and start playing the animation to check the final result. Well, I hope this short tutorial was helpful. See you soon.